the most beautiful place in the world, where a Tar Heel blue sky blankets Murphy on its way to the Tennessee border. It's a long way from Raleigh and the Outer Banks, but we're living in Carolina too. In fact, you might call it extreme Carolina. With more, here's Michael Borkman.
Welcome everyone to the show, Extreme Carolina, a show that focuses on great people with great stories who prove in their everyday lives that anything is possible. We strive to bring you relatable life lessons from interesting and inspiring people as they live out their purpose on this earth. And today, folks, we have an amazing, awesome guy, a friend of mine, and that we went to class together about a year ago now. And his name is Nick Oliver, and he's an amazing guy. He is the construction ministry coordinator over at Hinton Center in Hayesville. I mean, he does a lot of stuff, and they've got some new initiatives coming out. He's going to talk to us about them today, about the building and repair ministry. And they do a lot of things to help with the Healthy Homes initiatives through a holistic approach and to really help in the community. So we want to just say good morning and welcome, Nick.
Thank you, Michael, for having me.
Hey, man. Well, that's great, man. We're glad you're here. And I tell you what, let's just dig right into it. Let's get right at it. And so now, with you being working with our good friend, Miss Jackie, shout out to her and old Ricky. Yeah, because we had a good time out there when we did the class together. And we won't.
Leadership Chateau.
Yeah, the Leadership Chateau. Great one. Matter of fact, they about to start another one.
Yeah, just starting.
Yeah, yep. Okay. So I'm sure, man, those folks are going to have a good time. But now let's do it. Now, what we do here, Nick, we like to ask each guest that's here sitting in the chair. Because all of us, at some point in time of our life, we've had setbacks, we've had failures. And what we like to do is to ask our guests when they had a big one or one that really, that's a memorable one that happened to them, what did they do to move forward? So if you have a little short one that you'd like to share with us, or if you do, then please share it with us, a time that you failed and came back from
it. I think about times when I have felt like I was at the bottom or felt like I couldn't move forward, and I would ask friends around me for advice and to gain perspective, to realize that I wasn't on the bottom and that I had many choices still in front of me as to what to do next.
Okay.
And given that choice and having free will is an amazing thing. You think you got two choices, positivity or negativity, and you could beat yourself up, but you could just move forward. That's my way of dealing with that setbacks, is just
awesome.
Thinking okay. about opportunities forward.
And not waddling in the mud, hollering, woe is me. I mean, you're doing something. That's a good yeah. thing to get people that you trust and people that you know and know you and ask for advice.
And I think they appreciate that. That also gives them immediate perspective. Hey, a friend of mine is going through something, and now I'm of value. So those people that are good friends usually step up for you and really support you.
Awesome. Well, thanks for sharing that, Nick. Yeah. We appreciate that. And we're going to keep it going. Now, but we want to talk a little bit about why you're here. Now,
sure.
We talked about your job title and that you're the constructions ministry coordinator. So you coordinate a lot of the different construction projects that's
yeah.
going on at Hinton Center. So, but now there's a new particular type thing that you guys got coming out with the holistic approach and all that. Kind of share a little bit of that with us.
Yeah, well, our new emphasis for the building repairs ministry is the Safe and Healthy Homes Initiative.
Mm-hmm.
It's a holistic approach that strategizes. Sorry. It's an approach that strategically addresses the issues in the home that are most likely to affect the residents in the home.
Okay. Some like mold and stuff that we let grow instead of getting it took care of.
You got it. It was, we started this program originally based off of a study done, our quality of life study conducted by UNC Greensboro Center of Housing and Community Studies.
Mm-hmm.
The research noted connections between inadequate housing and poor health,
Right.
And at that point, we began researching the factors of housing that contribute most to poor health and safety. Nice. And created a safe and healthy homes checklist. Air quality, like you said, mold, fire hazards, medicine and chemical storage are some issues that are easily overlooked by one or more members of a household. So.
Awesome. Okay. All right. So Hinton, the Rural Life Center, this is not a new thing because they've been doing a lot of things, but mostly they've been known for just coming over and helping people who needed a railing put up or something of that nature.
Correct, and we'll still be doing that. That is definitely in the safe and healthy homes. Like your passageways coming in and out of your home, the egress, the lighting,
right.
The hallways, clutter in the stairs, these are all things that are huge. They are big drivers for the medical industry. Mm-hmm. People trip and fall. And don't have stable handrails.
You know, that is something. I got a question on that, but I want to just reset real quick for our listeners. Thank you for stopping on the dial of 95.1 here at WJRB, the show, Extreme Carolina. We appreciate you stopping. Today we're talking to Nick Oliver of the Hinton Rural Life Center, and we're talking about the things that they're doing. They're up in their game. They've been coming to folks' houses, people who needed it. Needed things done to their homes in and around them. So let's say that I was living at home, me and my spouse, and we're elderly, and we got some concrete steps when we should have an easy walk up, and I've fallen, you know, scraped my head or whatever, you know, and time to time. So we need something done. Can we call you guys and?
Sure. There's no financial requirement for the healthy homes assessment. We'll come out and help you think through problems of your home. Anything, anybody. We want to get information about our homes in our community and know what our needs. There are big environmental factors. I mean, it's obvious when a handrail is loose. There are some other factors that are invisible.
Right. Okay. Yeah,
so we're trying to kind of collect a lot of information to know what a focus would be in the future.
Okay.
We may focus on air quality. We may focus on mold. It just is house by house, basically.
So how would I get in touch if I'm thinking I've got, and my wife been on me, you know, we need to get a rail. Well, we're both elderly, or we've got some physical incapacity. Capacities that we can't do things. So who would we call? I mean, is there a number? Is there a website? I mean, how do we get a hold of you guys?
Right. So you can find the Safe and Healthy Homes checklist on our website, which is hintoncenter.org.
Mm-hmm.
And then also the phone number for the Hinton Center's local in the book, but I'll dictate it right now.
Please
it's 828-389-8336.
Say it one more time, please.
828-389-8336.
Okay. Awesome. What we're going to also do is put that on the show notes of our Facebook page because we got a lot of people, thousands of them, listening to this show. And so we'll put that information on there, including the website, because you say people can go to the website before they ever call you. And
correct.
There's a checklist of things there. Did I hear you say that correctly?
There is a form to fill out to request a check to be done.
Okay.
I'm not sure if the actual checklist is online, but I'll get back to you on that.
Okay, all right. But at least they can still go to the website
and
start the process.
Yes, and if you fill out an application, I'd be happy to go over what's on the checklist with anybody who asks.
You go. We're going to put that website address on our show notes page so people can know that because we want to get into that because that's really, really important to be able to have access because a lot of people probably don't even know you guys do this stuff.
Well, that's true. People have all kinds of ideas of what we've done in the past and what we are doing in the future, but that's what I'm here for, is to kind of introduce this program and flesh it out for folks.
Well, we are glad you're here today to do that. So I tell you what, we're going to talk more about that, but we got to step aside right now for our sponsors. You know, they sponsor us, so we got to give them an opportunity to jump in, say what they're going to say, and then we'll be right back. So don't go away, folks. We'll be right back with Mr. Nick Oliver from the Hinton Center. at Extreme Carolina.
Tar Heel basketball, Cam's Panthers, Asheville's eclectic nightlife, and the Great Smoky Mountains. It belongs to us, too, out here in Extreme Carolina. Once again, here's Michael Borkman.
Welcome back, everyone. Welcome back to the show, Extreme Carolina. Today, we've got Mr. Nick Oliver in the house, and we're having a great time talking about the things that they're doing over at Hinton Rural Life Center and with their new initiative that they're rolling out with the center's building and repair ministry. It's a big ministry, too. I mean, you guys have, and it ain't new. You guys have been doing it for quite some time. How long do you think this has been going on?
Over 50 years.
Wow. 50 years. Wow. Uh-huh. Okay, well, you're not that old, so you hadn't been there that long.
No, this is, I'm going on my fourth year being there now. Okay. And, the programs have changed over the years.
Yeah.
They used to build houses. Right. They used to repair houses in Robbinsville. You know, we've been kind of all over the place. Yeah. Yeah. There was a larger workforce at the Hinton Center in the 90s, and, mm-hmm. and now we're smaller, and we're just doing with what we have. Right. So
more efficient. Smaller, yep. More right on point.
That's right.
Okay, all right.
We're able to focus.
Yeah. So it looks like, you know, I read some of the stuff that you sent me, and it's you guys' goal now from the 90s and the 60s and all that stuff down to the 2000s, the 21st century.
Exactly.
And that is to repair homes and ultimately to help families to improve their health and safety by identifying some of those mitigating and negative environmental factors.
That's right. Getting rid of them, identifying them, that's going to improve the health of our community.
Okay. So you were saying that we were off the air and we talked a little bit about that. You said that it could be based on your zip code that you could be in trouble and don't know it.
Correct. It's written that your zip code is a better predictor of your health than your genetics. I mean, people fret about that. They worry about diabetes. They worry about mm-hmm. early onset Alzheimer's. But the environmental factors you live and sleep in, mm-hmm. those are the factors that can potentially influence your health greatly or greater than anything else.
Wow. So the way, and we're just going right along, just blind to the fact, don't even know this is happening. So
correct.
If we're interested in finding out if we're at risk, then we need to reach out to the Hinton Center.
Correct.
I mean, that's one of the ways that we can at least get the process started. Because also, you had mentioned to us off the air, you were talking, actually you may have mentioned it on the other side, that it doesn't cost anything to start the process, to even
correct.
get that. But there's also, there could be some unforeseen mitigating factors. And if that happens, what happens?
Right. So there is no financial requirement for our Safe and Healthy Homes check.
Okay.
But were there to be repairs needed, it's possible there may need to be a special circumstance or financial need that isn't being met. And right. those would be times we would consider helping.
Got it.
With the physical repair.
But that's just strictly on an individual basis.
Exactly.
You know, it's not like a big, everybody has to go through this, go through that, or can go through this and go through that. You got to look at individual setups and everything like that.
Correct.
Okay. All right. Well, great. Well, we're going to have that website and the phone number on our Extreme Carolina Facebook page so people can check it. But
thank
just
you.
Give the folks that number one more time.
Sure. Hinton Center can be reached at 828-389-8336. And the application can be found online at hintoncenter.org.
Gotcha. And so if they want to dial that number and they will ask for what is, you know, they're like, I don't know who I need to talk to. What would they, or who would they ask for?
Just say that you're calling to apply for a Safe and Healthy Homes check.
Safe and Healthy Homes. The key words in there.
Yes.
All right.
Yeah. If we pursue this, you know, our goal is to make repairs to homes and ultimately help families improve their health and safety by identifying and mitigating negative environmental factors that reduce the quality of life through increased illness, medical expenses, and diminished ability to work and care for themselves and our community.
Awesome. That's nice, man. That's a good job you guys are doing at the Hinton Center, for sure. I'm glad that we could help get the word out with Extreme Carolina. We really appreciate doing that. And you're one of the guys behind, well, you're not behind the scenes. You're on the scene. You're one of the guys that actually come to somebody's house.
Correct.
And check it out. So the folks will know just a little bit about who you are. You know, of course, there are some other folks involved. But we like to ask a little, one, two questions about the people who actually do this stuff.
Sure.
Nick, you're one of the guys. And so we like to ask questions, and they're really simple, basic questions. And one of the ones we like to ask is that, and this one is really, I love this one. It is, what's the best advice that you've ever received in your life?
Well, a good old country boy told me one time, your mouth will hang you. He said it with some slang. He said it like, your mouth will hang you. You know, he was talking about a coworker having a disagreement,
mm-hmm.
And arguing and complaining, and that attitude was not benefiting him, you know, whatsoever, and it was not going to help him get what he wanted. Mm-hmm. But from that, I took it as I saw the negativity, I saw mm-hmm. what was happening, and I realized at that moment I was going to make every attempt to just be positive
right.
with all of my statements. And try to control myself. You know, it's, you know, they talk about putting your foot in your mouth, but, you know, it's the things that come out of your mouth
that's right.
that are irreversible. So.
That's right. As long as they stay in, you got a shot.
Right.
But
right.
once they come out, you can't bring it back.
Right. And negativity is contagious. So as yes, soon as you spout it out, someone else has the willingness, then it seems mm-hmm. like to also become negative. And it spirals. Yeah.
Out of control. Okay. Well, thanks for that advice. Now, we also like to, Nick, we like to ask the people that are here about reading, because reading is a lost art. People, like, read everything with their phones, you know, with their laptops or whatever. But and nothing wrong with that. You still read. But we like to, as long as you're reading, which is the key, actually reading something.
Sure.
So we like to ask, what book have you read recently that had the biggest impact on you and why?
Well, I read a book by Horace Capehart. It's called Smoky Mountain Magic, and it's a novel, actually, and Horace Capehart isn't famous for writing novels. He wrote about historical reference and camping guides and living in the country, but he started life as a librarian in Boston. He went to several universities. He had wife and children, and mm-hmm. then left and became a woodsman and a hermit and a writer. And he had a crazy life journey, but it led to the establishment of the Great Smoky Mountains National Park. His writings did.
Mm.
And so he had trials and tribulations and failures. And there's probably some people out there that really don't like him. And then mm-hmm. also you have to appreciate what he was able to accomplish.
Right.
So I think seeing a person from multiple perspectives helps you understand their life journey uh-huh. and appreciate them, even though they may have done some bad things. Mm. So it helps me appreciate my life journey too. Not as complicated as his, thank goodness. I enjoy that book. It was just a fun little right. release, and then learning about
right.
Horace.
Yeah, so. had an impact on you.
Yeah, it did. That. It okay. did.
Well, so. That's great, man. Well, thanks for sharing that with us, Nick. We want to also, each of us are leaders. Some of us are leaders with titles. Some of us don't have titles. You just happen to have one. And so the question here is simply this. In your view, what does it take to be a leader?
Oh, a leader has to dedicate themselves to leadership with constant communication to all parties involved,
mm-hmm.
Pushing themselves to...
Right.
make it happen, marshaling the guts of whatever it is you're trying to lead, and also positively affecting
right.
the group
awesome.
Along the way.
Okay. Well, thank you, man. I appreciate that. Appreciate you sharing that with us. Man, I tell you what, I wish we had a whole bunch of time to get into this, but the only thing, well, not the only thing, but one of the things that I really appreciate about you guys is doing that quality of life. And I remember reading that study, and that was a thick book too. And, but anyway, we want to thank you for coming here on the show today. And, I'm, man, we're up against the wall. I've got to shut it down. I mean, it's just,
I appreciate it, Michael.
But thanks for coming. We'll put that on the Facebook page so everybody will know about it. And thanks for coming, Nick Oliver. So we're getting down to it. Ultimately, Extreme Carolina is committed to you, our listeners, to bring you leaders and newsmakers that are passionate and purpose-driven like Nick here is today. So by listening to their stories, Extreme Carolina listeners will have an opportunity to refuel, reconnect, and get inspired by unlocking the power of the people. Quote of the week, drum roll, here we go, positive quote of the week. It simply says this: living in the moment means letting go of the past and not waiting for the future. It means living your life consciously, aware that each moment you breathe is a gift. So thank you, everybody. Thank Nick Henson and everybody. Y'all go check them out. They're doing great things for the community. I really appreciate it very, very much. And we're just so happy here at Extreme Carolina. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and out there. We appreciate you. God bless y'all. We love you. Peace. We out. Heading down south to the land of the pines. I'm thumbing my way into North Carolina. Staring up the road and pray to God I